My name is Jim Bridenstine. I'm the executive director and have been for almost 25 years of the Kalamazoo Institute of Arts, the finest visual arts institution between Detroit and Chicago. You know, the thing that's wonderful is that the mission of this institution is the same today as it was when we were founded in 1924.
The KI really started, way back when a bunch of artists got together at the studio of Kathleen Wood down in the Praying Building, and they said, you know, we'd really like to create something that, you know, teaches classes, that brings in speakers, that has exhibits, and what can we do? So that was how it started. So it was almost from the ground up, really. 1924 is when they officially came into being. Very humble beginnings. They were located there at the YMCA, and then they went on, became under the jurisdiction of the library. And finally, 1947, they actually got their own building, and that really began the modern sort of KIA.
For people in my demographic in this community, the building, that wonderful building that came early in the 60s and gave a real focus to the arts in this community, that was so special.
But again, there's this idea that, you know, kind of what can we do more? How can we bring people in? And so there was a gentleman named Clarence Leininger. He later became the head of the board of directors for a number of years. And one day he was having a conversation with a local reporter from the Kalamazoo Gazette named Philip White. And they came up with the idea, well, what if we just invited any artist who wants to can string a clothesline between trees in Bronson Park and display their works. And, you know, this was a huge success. I think we're like the second longest continuous running art fair in the country. So in a way, the art fair led to the new building by showing there was this interest. So.
I remember when that the date when the ribbon was cut, you know, that just signaled such a renaissance of the art in this community, a very exciting time. I will never forget that.
And that's where the Gilmore family really became involved.
My name is Martha Parfitt, and it was my mother and father, Jane and Donald Gilmore, who in the late 1950s started thinking about improving the already existing KIA and realized that it was so popular they needed to make it bigger. So here we are at the new KIA.
Before I came, we didn't have a facility. We didn't have a reputation. We didn't have the means to do an international exhibition. What we do now.
You know, I'm always amazed, you know, this place exists in a place of size. You know, when I think when I was younger, you think, got to get out of here, got to do something else. But after a while, again, you discover these people and the environment, and you suddenly kind of discover this is an interesting part of the world right here.
I think one of the greatest strengths of the KIA is the fact that not only does it have a very fine, permanent collection, but it also has a school.
Well, the Kirk Newman School of Art exists because the institution of the Kalamazoo Institute of Art began as an art center. And as an art center, it was a school and an art gallery. And they had classes in an old building down here in this area. And when they moved into this building in 1961, they created half of the building as an art museum and half of it as a professional art school.
When the building opened in the 1960s, there might be 400 students a year. The institution now may have 4,000 students a year.
Mom and Dad were very enthusiastic about creating, as she said, the school and the museum. Important part for both.
Well, as I look back over 25 years, I think the institution has improved, achieved incredible things.
No institution that just keeps doing what it's always done in the face of social change can be very vibrant.
As an institution, the Kalamazoo Institute of Art, regardless of who is here as staff, has grown and will continue to grow and will, I am sure, maintain the high quality and that level of excellence that we've had in the past.
I think this place has a lot of vitality and different odd, sometimes quiet ways, but you know, it stays interesting.
I think you should take, as a member of this community, a certain pride in the quality of what you can find at the Kalamazoo Institute of Arts, in the classes that you could take, the temporary exhibitions you could see, the permanent collection we have. And I'm saying that to you because my colleagues who come from larger art institutions throughout the country say to me, I don't believe what you have here. The quality is so good. You're very fortunate to have it. Kalamazoo, Kalamazoo community, Southwest Michigan, you're fortunate to have the Kalamazoo Institute of Arts.
Thank you.